Yeah, hey Russ, our question of the day that we
haven't asked
that we rarely get to, but we're asking someone today because you're there. Do other countries know what a crawfish and shrimp boil is? And
because we have one coming up next week.
Yeah. Huh?
Say it again. The last one.
And why would we do that?
Yeah. So a crawfish. Do you know what crawfish is?
Yeah. Yeah.
So are those common where you are? I mean,
big time.
Oh really?
We call them rak, which is the same word as cancer, by the way.
Oh.
Ouch.
So you're going to cancer boils?
Wow.
Well, because if you look at the astrological signs of it, it's called cancer.
Type of cancer.
Right, because it's it looks akin to the astrological symbol.
Yeah. So and there's even the saying. You have the saying once in a blue moon, and we have a saying once the crawfish will whistle on a mountain. You know, that when it happens. That means it's very rare when the crawfish will whistle on a mountain.
Wow, just the idea of a crawfish whistling at all, it seems pretty rare.
So that is not, as far as that's not an astronomical thing, whereas astronomical, because that cancer, well, astrological, well, the stars.
Yeah, it's
are we talking about the horoscope or the stars?
Astrology is the mythical side of astronomy.
That would be the horoscope side.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. So it's not a reference to where the stars are over a certain mountain that happens once ever so.
Talking to literally a crawfish on top of a mountain whistling.
So, yeah. But I would pay to see that.
Yeah, that's not happening.
Not happen at all.
Or like you guys saying it once in a blue moon. Very rare occasion.
No, but I mean, the thing is when you get into idioms, I mean, those often do not translate. If you have somebody who can actually translate an idiom into another culture's idiom, that means you really understand all of it. Yeah. I mean, that's like an advanced thing.